Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty. It's Artcast 518. Let's get going. Let's do some drawing. So the 100 days of comics is over, and it's funny. I'm feeling all directionless, not having to make videos every day. So I don't know. I might have to start again. Not the 100 days, but making daily videos again. I wanted to answer a question that I've been getting quite a bit lately, and I keep trying to answer each person, but I guess I miss people. From time to time. So Trevor Schmidt says, "Hey Jeff, a quick question. I'm sure you've mentioned it before, but I can't find it looking back on your stuff. What kind of paper have you been using? It looks really durable and workable. I haven't found paper that can accommodate my needs for similar work." So now, let's see, Almighty Jack actually responded. A couple people responded. He says, "I think he uses normal Bristol board that most comic artists use, but in order to prevent the warping, Jeff applies a layer of gesso to the back of the paper. I remember him mentioning it in a video a while back, but I'm not sure which one." You got it kind of right, but not quite. Then Max Falto said, came back and he says, gesso to the back or the front with a question mark. "I don't want to goof up my art before I start painting. I bought a bottle of clear gesso to work on pencil illustrations." And then, let's see, Almighty Jack said, "You can probably do either or both. It really depends on the warping of the piece. Gesso bonds to the paper and makes it contract, so it stiffens up the surface. If you're using clear coats, you can apply it to the back first, work on the piece, and if it starts to warp, either apply another layer to the back or apply one to the front or vice versa." Okay, so let me show you guys something. So this is like a current page that I've finished here a little while ago. And this is on Letramax 2200. That's the board name. Now, I don't even know if they make this board anymore. This is some board that I had out in my flat file out in the shed. And I've just been using it up. So, but basically, this is just your standard illustration board, and it's just like the crescent illustration board or any other kind of, you know, illustration board. Go to the art store, ask for illustration board, and this is what you get. It's not Bristol. Bristol is like a paper that's like thinner than this, but it's an actual board, so it's kind of over by the mat boards and that kind of stuff. I do gesso it. Now, the way I gesso is I put gesso on the front, and then on the back I just wet it down. So I take my brush, I dip it in some water, I put water on the back, soak the back of the board, flip it over, and gesso the front. Now why I do that is because then as the board dries, it doesn't curl into like a weird shape because it's drying on both sides at the same time. And I do that each time I gesso it. And I usually put like 3 coats of gesso on. The clear gesso, now this is like something a lot of people have been asking me, wanting me to talk about. I don't have any experience with clear gesso. I don't know if it's good, it's bad. I always buy white gesso. To me, like, gesso is supposed to be white. I don't know why they're making it clear now, but I buy the white gesso because that's the stuff that I've used for years, and yeah, that's it. Now, when I started drawing the comic, let me show you guys this. This is a page from the comic that somebody actually just grabbed off the Indiegogo. I need to mail. Now this is like on paper. This, when I started the comic, I just kind of started it as just a quick thing that I was going to do on the side of my work, and it wasn't going to become my main thing. And so I didn't really think about like what I was painting on. I was just grabbing like the brochure paper that I copy on. So like, the actual stuff, let me grab it, is this stuff. It's just HP brochure paper, basically, without the folds. And it's just like a thicker paper. And I don't gesso it. I just draw on it and paint on it. And it works okay, but as I've went on with the comic and I've wanted to make the art more impressive, that's kind of why I started putting them all together on one piece of paper. And gessoing it and just making it into like a really nice piece that somebody was really going to want to own later. Now let me tell you guys something else. Well, this one right here, This is a nude that I'm painting for a guy. And it's on, if you guys can see that. This is MDF, which is a manufactured board that you pick up at like places like Home Depot or a lumber yard or something like that. And you can see it's decently thick. And I paint on this raw, and then I also paint on a gesso. And so like this one, I think it maybe has one coat of gesso. I don't usually gesso this stuff up like with three coats, because since it is a slick surface, it's really hard for me to paint on if I get it really slick. You know what I mean? I can turn this thing into like an ice skating rink. And that's why, like with this stuff, I don't gesso it heavily. I just one time. You know what I mean? And there it is, gessoed on the back too. The only reason the back is gessoed on this one is because when I buy the stuff, it's like in a big sheet. I just gesso up the whole sheet, both sides, and then it's ready to paint, and then I just cut pieces out. If you're looking for something durable, this is durable. This is going to last. They're going to be around in a couple hundred years unless people just throw them in the trash. You know what I mean? The pieces on paper, maybe, maybe not. But, you know, to do a whole comic book on this stuff, I'd have a pretty big stack, you know, of stuff. I mean, look how thick that is. I'd have like a big stack of pages. I mean, there's a lot of art in a comic. So anyway, I hope that answers your question there. I guess the answer is, it's like, it depends on which video you're watching as to what I'm painting on. I don't necessarily paint on one thing. And that actually isn't even, that's like what I paint on usually. One of those three things. It's either illustration board with gesso on it, or maybe even raw illustration board. I haven't done that for a while, but I have done that. MDF. I love painting on MDF. It's awesome. I mean, it's like a great surface, and it's great to paint on. And anytime I do any kind of portrait type stuff, I stick it on MDF. I like drawing on paper too, because it's immediate. You mess it up, you just throw it away. You pull out another piece of paper, you just go to town, and it's ready to go. But then there's other stuff, you know. It's like I sometimes paint on canvas. This piece up here is canvas. It's a stretch canvas that I gessoed. I also buy these pre-stretched canvases, these Frederick boards, these ones. They're pretty rough. Sometimes I'll give them a sand, and I usually gesso them just to kind of get that texture down a little bit. But they're pre-gessoed. You could just get them, paint on them. You know, the answer is really, it's like whatever fits you. Just try some stuff and figure out what's good. I don't really have the answers as to like what the best thing is. Hopefully that answers some of you guys' questions. So that's it. The Berserkonaut is actually over on Indiegogo InDemand a while yet. I know I've been saying that for a while, but it'll probably be up till the end of this month. Go check it out if you want to pick up a copy. What else? Sign up for the mailing list if you need a notification every time a video goes up. I'll send you one. And also Patreon. I'm on Patreon. If you guys want to support the channel, you can sign up on Patreon. You get your name at the end of the video if you do. And I've got some Patreon exclusive videos over there. I'll see you guys later.